Mycobacterium leprae. Morphology. They are gram-positive bacillus. They are acid fast, but less than tubercle bacillus. They can occur singly and can also occur in groups. They can be both intracellular and also extracellular. The bacilli are bound together by lipid-like substance called as glia. This is the glia. And the entire masses are called as globi. They are arranged in cigar bundle appearance. They appear in virtuous leprae cells or foamy cells, which are large undifferentiated histiocytes. Let's now see about leprosy. Leprosy is a chronic granulomatous disease of humans. It predominantly involves skin, peripheral nerves, and nasal mucosa. Types of leprosy. It can be classified into four major types and one subtype. Lepromatous leprosy, referred to as LL, and tuberculoid leprosy, TT. These are the two main types. Third is dimorphous, also called as borderline tuberculosis. This is further of two types, borderline tuberculoid and borderline lepromatous. They refer to lesions possessing characteristics both tuberculoid and lepromatous types. It may shift depending on chemotherapy or alterations in the host resistance. The indeterminate type, I. This is the early unstable tissue reaction. In many persons, the indeterminate lesions undergo spontaneous healing. In others, they may progress to the tuberculoid or lepromatous types. Pure neuritic type. It is bacteriologically negative and there is neural involvement without any skin lesion. See the two main types of leprosy, lepromatous leprosy and tuberculoid leprosy. In lepromatous leprosy, the host resistance is low, and in tuberculoid, there is high degree of resistance. Lepromatous, the bacilli are found in large numbers, so this is referred to as multibacillary disease. In tuberculoid leprosy, the bacilli are very scanty, so this is referred to as posibacillary disease. In lepromatous leprosy, the superficial nodular lesions, lepromata, are seen, which lead to ulceration of nodules, progressive secondary infection, which can cause distortion and mutilation. In tuberculoid leprosy, the skin lesions are few and they are sharply demarcated. They consist of macular and aesthetic patches. The lepromatous leprosy stage is more infective than tuberculoid leprosy, which has minimal infectivity. The lepromatous leprosy has poor prognosis, whereas tuberculoid leprosy has good prognosis. Lepromatous leprosy, there is deficient cell-mediated immunity and exaggerated humoral immune response, which leads to production of more autoantibodies. In tuberculoid leprosy, there is adequate cell-mediated immunity, so the autoantibodies are rare. And lepromatous leprosy, the lepromin test is negative, whereas in tuberculoid leprosy, the lepromin test is positive. Genetic predisposition. The HLA-DR2 is seen predominantly in persons with tuberculoid type of reaction, and HLA-MTI and HLA-DQ1 are seen in persons with lepromatous disease. The infection with the lepra bacilli stimulates the humoral and cell immune response. If there's deficient cell-mediated immunity, lepromatous leprosy develops. Delayed hypersensitivity to lepra bacillus is absent. The predominant lymphocytes seen here are CD8 plus cells, that is cytotoxic T cells. And in leprosy, there is reversal of albumin globulin ratio. Let's now see about lepra reactions. These are of two types, type 1 and type 2. The type 1 are also called reversal reaction or lepra reaction. These are most commonly seen with borderline leprosy. The lesions here are erythema, swelling with pain and tenderness is seen. In biopsy, there is shift to lepromatous pattern. Type 2 is called erythema nodosum leprosum. This is common with lepromatous leprosy and borderline lepromatous types. There are crops of tender, inflamed subcutaneous nodules with presence of fever, lymphadenopathy, and arthralgia. The characteristic is there's neutrophilic infiltration, immunoglobulin G, and complement deposition in the lesions. Let's now see about lepromin test. The standard lepromins, those from lepromin A, are injected, which produces two types of reactions: early reaction of Fernandez and late reaction of Mitsuda. The early reaction of Fernandez consists of erythema and induration developing in 24 to 48 hours, and it remains for 3 to 5 days. This is similar to the tuberculin reaction. The late reaction, this starts in 1 to 2 weeks. It reaches peak in 4 weeks and it gradually subsides in the next few weeks. This consists of indurated skin nodule which may ulcerate. The healthy persons in non-endemic areas with no chance of contact with bacillus are positive to lepromin test. The applied importance of lepromin test. This is used to classify lesions. This is positive in tuberculoid and negative in lepromatous leprosy. And this is variable in dimorphous and indeterminate types of disease. Second, to access the prognosis and response to the treatment. The positive reaction indicates good prognosis. To assess the resistance and to verify the identity of candidate lepra bacilli. Lab diagnosis. This is easy in lepromatous leprosy and is difficult in tuberculoid leprosy. The specimen collected are nasal smear, skin smear, slit skin smear, or nerve biopsy. Microscopy. Demonstration of acid-fast bacilli in lesions. And grading is done based on number of bacilli to see the severity of the disease. The stain used is Ziehl-Neelsen stain using 5% of H2SO4, sulfuric acid. Culture. Mouse foot pad inoculation and armadillo. The 9-banded armadillo is highly susceptible to infection with Mycobacterium leprae. Serology. Here there is detection of antibody against Mycobacterium leprae phenolic glycolipid antigen. Treatment of leprosy. Dapsone. This was the first effective drug, but this has now become resistant for monotherapy. The multi-drug therapy in leprosy. For posse bacillary lesions, rifampicin 600 mg once a month is given along with dapsone 100 mg daily for 6 months. The possibacillary lesions include indeterminate tuberculous and borderline tuberculous types. Next, for multibacillary lesions, which include borderline, borderline lepromatous and lepromatous leprosy. The treatment is rifampicin 600 mg once a month along with dapsone 100 mg daily for 2 years added with clofazimine 50 mg daily for 2 years. And there should be follow-up after 4 years minimum in possibacillary lesions and after 8 years minimum in multibacillary lesions to check for any relapse. Prophylaxis. The prophylaxis includes case finding and their adequate therapy. Long-term chemoprophylaxis is done in children who are in contact with the infectious cases. And there is no specific vaccine available. Thank you.